Well friends, in this video we shall discuss regarding painting, coloring and varnishing. So as a part of protective coatings, the first protective coating, that is plastering as well as painting, we have discussed in detail. In today's video we shall discuss regarding paints and varnishes. So what is paint? Paint are the coatings of fluid material which are applied as a final finish to all surfaces such as walls, ceilings, woodwork, metalwork, etc. So painting is done to the walls, painting is done normally to the wooden surfaces, painting is done also to the metal surface, and this is the final finishing coat. The elegance of the structure or any element, it mostly depends upon the paint, because due to this paint everything will get concealed. The quality of the material, the workmanship, it will get concealed and it will attract the people. So paints are, selection of paint is very very important. The process application of paint as a coating, it is called as painting. The process of applying the paint, it is a painting. Now constituents of the paints, what are the ingredients? Constituent materials means the materials by which this paint is prepared. So base, vehicle, dryer, coloring pigment, solvent and fillers, these are the constituent materials of the paint. So what is base? A base is a solid substance of a metallic oxide in fine state of division. It is a principal constituent of paint. The base makes the paint film harder, stronger, elastic, safe against cracking and moisture. So base is a principal constituent, major constituent of the paint, and it provides hardness, strongness, elasticity to the paint. So if proper base is there, cracking will get avoided. Next is vehicle. A vehicle is a liquid substance which keeps the ingredients of paint in liquid suspension. The function of the vehicle is, it keeps all the ingredients of the paints in liquid suspension. It dries on exposure. So normally in case of paint, you might have observed when a tin of paint is open and it is used afterwards, if it remains open, in that case it will get dried, right? Normally during the use, the tins, the caps of the tins are properly packed so that the paint will not get dried. So the use of vehicle is to keep the ingredients of the paints in liquid suspension. It acts as a catalyst in the oxidation process of the drying oils. So it acts as a catalyst, it accelerates the drying process when it comes in contact with oxygen. So it works as a catalyst for oxidation. Next is coloring pigment. Coloring pigment, as name suggests, coloring pigment gives required color for paints. So whatever shade is required, it depends upon the coloring pigment. So coloring pigment gives required color or required shade to the paints. Solvent, as name says, solvent, it is a volatile liquid which is mixed in a paint to make the paint thin so that it can be easily applied on the surface. It must exhibit capacity of taking all the other components into solution and evaporating quickly on exposure to the atmosphere. So solvent, it makes the paint thinner so it can be very easily applied on the surface. So this is the function of solvent, to make the paint more thinner. It increases the viscosity so it can be applied on the surface very easily. Fillers, as name suggests, fillers, this can be added to paint to increase the bulk volume without affecting its useful properties. Materials used for fillers are inert. So fillers, only use of the filler is to increase the volume of the paint. It is inert material, it is not having any effect on the quality, on the properties of the this paint. So it is called as filler, it is a inert material. So this is all about constituents of the paints. Now properties of an ideal paint, what are the properties, the required good properties of the ideal paint? It should be possible to apply easily and freely. It should be easily applicable. It should dry in a reasonable time. It should form hard and durable surface. It should not be easily affected by atmospheric effects. It should possess attractive and pleasing appearance. It should not be harmful to the health of the workers. It should have a good hardening power so as to cover the surface. It's applied on completely and thoroughly. It should be economical in cost. At the end, it should be economical. So what are the properties of nitrile? It should be easily applicable. It should dry within reasonable time. It should form hard surface, durable surface. It should not be easily affected by the atmospheric air, sun, wind and rain. It should not become fed. After application, sometimes what happens? The paints become fed within the air. In that case, means the quality of the paint is not good. Sometimes what will happen? There are various types of defects in the paint. Scaling will be there of the paint. If it is adhere power, adhesion power is not good. It should produce attractive and pleasing appearance. It should not be harmful to the health of the worker. It should not be harmful. Whatever chemicals, those should not be harmful to the health of the workers. It should have a good binding power. It should get binded properly to the surface where it is applied. At the end, it should be economical. It should be affordable by the various people. Objectives of the paint. Why painting is done? It prevents decay of wood and corrosion of metals. In case of wood, it avoids the decay, it prevents the decay, and in case of metals, it avoids the corrosion, it reduces the corrosion. It is used to give good appearance to the surface. It is used to give good appearance, attractive appearance, pleasing appearance to the surface. It protects the surface from weathering effects of the atmosphere. It provides a smooth surface for easy cleaning. So these are the objectives of the paints or painting. Now, what are the types of paints? So, based on constituent which is used for preparation of the paint, major constituent material or base of the paint, there are different types of paints: aluminium paint, oil paint, enamel paint, bituminous paint, emulsion paint, and distempers. All of these types of paint. In this video, we shall discuss only distempers in detail. So aluminum paint means what? It is the paint where finely ground aluminum in spirit or oil varnish is used, or oil varnish is used. It is widely used for painting gas tanks, water pipes and tanks. Aluminum paint, it is used only for painting gas tanks because it is very costly. Aluminum paint is very costly and it consists of finely ground aluminum in spirit. It consists of fine granules of aluminium in spirit or oil varnish. It is used for painting gas tanks, water pipes and water tanks. Oil paint. This is the ordinary paint and it is generally applied in three coats of varying composition. Oil paint can be used for wall surfaces, it can be used for wooden surface, it can be used for metal surfaces, because in case of this, the base is oil, it is oil bound. The oil paints are used in general for all types of surfaces such as wood, woodwork, walls, ceiling, metalwork, etc. They have a low order shine. They contain unsaturated oil. They contain the bases of unsaturated oil. So for mixing of the oil paint, what is not used? So here the base is the oil and their hardening is because of oxidation of the oil on exposure to the atmosphere, already we have discussed. Next, enamel paint. It contains white lead or zinc white, oil, petroleum spirit and resinous material. Enamel paint, it contains white lead or zinc white, oil, petroleum spirit and resinous material. It can be used for both external as well as internal walls. It forms a hard impervious enamel like surface on drying, and that's why paint is called as enamel paint. Next is bituminous paint. This type of paint is manufactured by dissolving asphalt or vegetable bitumen oil or petroleum. It is used for painting ironworks underwater. So wherever corrosion is a problem, in that case, bituminous paint is used. It is also a costly paint. Emulsion paint. Normal emulsion paint, distempers and oil paint, these are used for painting walls for various types of building elements, walls, woods and metals also. So in case of this emulsion paint, it contains binding materials such as polyvinyl acetate, synthetic resins, etc. It can be defined as a suspension of one liquid within another. One liquid in this case is the paint source and the other a carrier. This paint is recommended for use on stucco, bricks and masonry surface which contain free alkali. So emulsion paint, it contains free alkali. Next is distemper. Distempers are the cheaper variety of paints in which chalk is used as a base and water is used as a carrier. So in case of distempers, water is used as a carrier. In case of oil paints, oil is used as a carrier. Emulsion also use water. So now we shall discuss in detail regarding distemper. Distemper paint is an ancient type of paint made up of chalk and coloring pigment and water used as a carrier. It is bound with either an animal glue or the adhesive qualities of casein, a resin that comes from solidified milk. The basic constituent of distemper paint is chalk, lime and water. Water used as a carrier, chalk gives base to this. Distemper paint is also known as cement paint. Distemper paints are also known as cement paints, and nowadays variety of cement paints are available in the market with various brand names. Different brand names are there, and distempers are widely used for economical painting of the buildings. This is called so because such kind of paint can be applied directly on cement walls without any other coating on them without using the primer. So no primer used for application of the distemper on the wall, and that's why it is called a cement paint, which can be directly applied on the cement surfaces. They are cheaper option, and yes, these are very economical. They stay good for more than 3 to 5 years. Minimum life is 3 years. After three years it becomes faded. So normally it lasts for a 5 years. 3 to 5 years is the life. Up to 3 years the color shade will get maintained, afterwards it become fade. Distemper paints are used for both interior and exterior walls. These will need two coatings. It is applied normally in two coats, first coat and second coat. No primer is required for this distemper. What are the properties of distemper? They are generally light in color. Distempers are light in color. They give a reflective coating. The coating is generally thick. They are less durable than oil paint. With compared to oil paint, because in case of oil paints, the base is oil. So obviously, life is more with compared to distemper. They exhibit poor workability. Distempers exhibit poor workability. Advantage of distemper. Distemper paint does not need any primer coating. This is the advantage. Can be directly applied on cement surface without any preparations. They are less expensive compared to other alternatives. They are very economical. They stay long and up to 3 to 5 years. Already I discussed it. It lasts for 5 years. But 3 years it will sustain very nicely. The shade will get maintained. The color will get maintained. After 3 years it may become faded. Some scaling may be there. They have a distinctive smell. It is having its one smell. They don't dry or crack in sunlight. That is most important. As base is water, they won't dry or crack in sunlight. So this is all about advantages. Coming to disadvantages of distempers, the quality will not be great while compared to other paints. The quality is poor with compared to emulsion paint, with compared to oil paints. Distemper paint peels off when wet. This is difficult. They peels off wet. It's not fully washable. Distempers are not washable. For emulsion paints and for oil paints, you can wash it. The stains can be removed very easily, but that is not possible in case of this distempers. It is not fully washable. Distemper paint color will fade time being quickly than emulsion paint. Already we have discussed it becomes fade after 3 years. But emulsion paint, oil paints will last for long period with compared to this distemper. So this is all about disadvantages. Now coming to varnish. Varnish is a solution of resin or resinous substances such as common resin, amber, copal, shellac, etc. in alcohol, turpentine or oil. So varnish is nothing but these are the resins. These are not available like a paint. These are in terms of solution of resins. It enhances and gives warmth to the grain of the wood and is resistant to impact, heat, abrasion, water and alcohol. The varnishes resist impact, resist the heat, resist the abrasion, water and alcohol. It can be used as a top coat over wooden finishes. Varnish is a clear, transparent, hard protective finish or film. Varnish has little or no color and has no added pigment as opposed to paint or wood stain which contains pigment. So in case of varnishes, no pigments are used. Right. So varnish has little or sometimes no color varnishing, because varnishing is used as coating only on the painted surface. That is important because varnish is not having any color. What are the objectives of varnish? To intensify or brighten the appearance of natural grains in wood. So varnishes are normally provided for wooden surfaces or wooden painted surfaces to brighten it, to intensify it, to render brilliancy to the painted surface, to render brilliancy or to enhance the paints, the beauty of the paint, to protect painted surface from atmospheric action, painted surface, to protect painted surface from atmospheric action, to protect unpainted wooden surface of those windows, roof trusses, floors, etc. from atmospheric. So these are the objectives of varnishes. So varnish itself is not having any color. No pigment is used in varnish. Normally varnish is provided on the painted surfaces, wooden surfaces, to enhance the beauty of wooden surfaces, to increase the life of wooden surfaces, to protect wooden surface from atmospheric effects, atmospheric actions. Characteristics of the good varnish: it should dry rapidly. This is very important. Normally in case of varnish, it takes more time to dry. It should form a hard film. After drying, it should form a hard film. It should not crack on drying. It should have sufficient elasticity. It should be durable and weather resistant. It should give uniform and pleasing appearance. It should not hide the natural grain of the inner surface of timber. This is very important. And it depends upon the skill of the person, the skill of the painter also. The color of varnish should not fade away with time. It should not become fade. Ingredients of the varnish: dryers, resins and solvents. These are the ingredients of varnish. No pigments are there. Dryers are there, resins are there, solvents are also there. Dryers accelerate the process of drying of varnish. Common dryers used in varnishes are litharge, white copper and lead acetate. These are the dryers which are used. So it accelerates the drying process. It increases the drying process of varnish. Now, resins are resinous substances. The quality of resin depends largely on the type of resin used. The quality of the resin depends largely on the type of resin used. Yes, what type of resin used? Because resins are nothing but the granules which are obtained from the trees. Various types of resins in use are copal, resin itself, shellac, umber, mastic, gum dammer, etc. Copal is a hard and lustrous resin. Copal, normally copal is used as it is hard and lustrous resin obtained from ground where pine trees existed in past. So already we have discussed resins are nothing but the granules from the trees, normally from the pine trees. So copal is the best resin. It is hard and lustrous and which is obtained from the pine tree. Resin is obtained from pine trees. Shellac is obtained by exudation of some insects which grow on some type of trees in India. Shellac is obtained from the insects which do on the trees. Next is the solvents. Boiled linseed oil, methylated spirit of wine, wood naphtha, umber, copal, shellac, mostek, gum dammer, and also the turpentine. These are the ingredients of varnish. Normally or most of the time turpentine is used as a solvent. So this is all about paints and varnishes as well as distempers. Hope you understood it. This part is very, very important. Normally we used to neglect all this part, but we should know what is meant by paint, what is distemper, what is an emulsion paint, what is enamel paint, what is oil paint, what are the various ingredients, which ingredient is good, which ingredient imparts what type of property to the paint. So this is very important. Hope you understood all these things.